or scheme two, but here's my free body diagram with all the red arrows turned black. And so the question is, do we have a free body diagram that's actually in equilibrium? And so just to prepare for what we're going to do, I'm going to take the two forces that are in the vertical direction. One is the applied external, one is a support force. At this point, it makes no difference as to where they came from. I'm just going to create a single resultant force from that. And so I end up with 2.08 going down. So the question is this thing in equilibrium? And I just need to choose an equation of equilibrium that I have not used yet. And so I'm going to get a little creative here, and I'm just going to create a point off the beam. I'm going to call it point D. Happens to be 4 meters below the right end and 3 meters to the right of the right end. Now, again, any location will work here. All right, so I've just defined exactly where point D is. And so to check here, I'm going to spin a moment about point D. And this will incorporate all the loads on my free body diagram. That's the most complete independent statics check that I can create. So I end up with a pretty long equation here. I get contributions from all five forces, one moment, and from the four loads, or the forces that are on my beam. And so if I work through the math here, I end up with not exactly 0 equals 0, but I end up with 0.04 newton meters is equal to 0. And at this point, we would have to determine, is that significant? And this becomes a percent error representation. So I want to compare this number that I just solved. And I know it's not exactly equal to 0, but quote, is it close enough? And the way we're going to do that is comparing it to what's in that equation. And so I'm just going to take 25 that's sitting right there, and I'm going to do a percent error analysis. So I'm going to take 0.04 divided by 25, multiply by 100, and I end up finding that the percentage error is going to be 0.16%. Generally in engineering, we're going to say pretty much anything less than 3% is okay. So we're well below that. So this is an acceptable round off error.